This morning, let's explore, let's ponder, what is emptiness? This is Lama Chagme Khyentse of the Buddha Joy Meditation School. Welcome to Meditate Like a Jedi. This is the Lama you are looking for. This morning, we could chant and we could chant and meditate and enjoy a lesson or two, but first, if you love Star Wars and you wish to meditate as transformatively as young Luke Skywalker on Dagobah under the guidance of Yoda, be sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell. If at any point during this morning's live stream, you have a question about Buddhist meditation or Buddhist philosophy or how to apply them to your life, there is no need to be bashful. Simply type your question in the chat window on the right-hand side of the screen. Type it as soon as the question occurs to you. Strike while the curiosity iron is hot. Do not make the mistake of waiting till the very end of the live stream. Well, so let's explore again. Let's stop the share and subject it to Jumbo Face. Hello, welcome to Jumbo Face. So when we read the Heart Sutra, a phrase we see, a word we see over again is empty, or sometimes we see its English synonym, which is void. What do we mean by that? Well, first of all, let's start off. Empty or void could be a verb or a noun. In the Buddhist in the context, and this creates a lot of confusion when newbies are listening to or reading classic discourses, which assume that everyone is really clear on what's going on. So we're not talking about emptying the mind or emptying thoughts. We're talking about not a verb, but an adjective. So what, for instance, if we say form is empty, well, what does that mean then? Empty of what? Now, there's two ways of exploring this. We can view it literally or figuratively. In the Tao Te Ching, we learn that those who follow the path of patriarchy tend to be very, very rigid and literal-minded, whereas those who follow the path of matriarchy tend to be flexible and open to the possibility that, not all communication is literal, that communication can, at least in potentiality, be figurative. So if we take a literalist point of view, we come to a fork in the road. Either we swan dive into the skullduggery, into pseudo-intellectual skullduggery, or we swan dive into superstition and blind faith, neither of which are going to help you to get really good at letting go. But if we explore the possibility that emptiness could be at least figurative, then that's one hurdle on the path to letting go. In previous live streams, we've discussed how every time we inhale, we access the sympathetic nervous system, which is wired for sensory acuity. It's wired not for concentration, which is rigid and excludes more than it perceives. It's wired for broad spectrum perception, to perceive vulnerably and passively and viscerally, and even, oopsie, randomly. Every time we exhale, we automatically access our parasympathetic nervous system, which is wired for both physical relaxation and mental release, which helps us to let go. So far, this is all very literal. Enter the figurative now. Whenever we relax into our exhalation, that which we perceived during our previous inhalation can now feel as non-graspable as if, see, that's the big signal, so you know a simile is coming, as if it was as non-graspable as a vast empty void. So any fourth grade teacher will tell you that the key to a successful simile is relatability. So what is a real world example of a non-graspable vast empty void? How about the illusion of the infinite azure sky on a bright and beautiful cloudless morn, which although could be tantalizing to the eye, got just my microphone, although it could be tantalizing to the eye, it is intangible to the hand. So there you have it. Emptiness is just a fancy way of saying non-graspable. So is the phrase birthless, deathless, or unborn, or no self. They're all different ways of saying the same thing. If you found this explanation helpful, then give this live stream a thumbs up. And of course, I extend a great big thank you to the folks who on Patreon keep these live streams ad-free and completely independent. What I'd like to do now is start this morning's formal practice. First of all, quick apology. My streaming service, OBS, recently upgraded, and I can no longer work with it. And I'm waiting to set an appointment with my consultant. So while that's going on, I'm having to do Zoom-oriented live streaming. And it's not perfect, but it's better than nothing. And I thank you for bearing with me. So welcome to the latest iteration of Easy Meditations Proto-Zen. We're going to begin by training in right aspiration and right zeals, second and six folds of the Eightfold Path. We're going to do this simply by chanting the recitations of bodhicitta and refuge. Please chant with me. May I liberate all beings from the tyranny of hating, craving, and clinging by relying on the Buddha's example, instructions, and students. May I liberate all beings from the tyranny of hating, craving, and clinging by relying on the Buddha's example, instructions, and students. May I liberate all beings from the tyranny of hating, craving, and clinging by relying on the Buddha's example, instructions, and students. Together, the first fold of the Buddha's Eightfold Path is the right view of letting go. Probably the easiest way to train on that is to simply chant the Heart of Wisdom Sutra. Let's use Red Pine's translation. The noble Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, while practicing the deep practice of Prajnaparamita, looked upon the five skandhas and seeing they were empty of self-existence, said here Shariputra form is emptiness, emptiness is form. Emptiness is not separate from form, form is not separate from emptiness. Whatever is form is emptiness, whatever is emptiness is form. The same holds for sensation and perception, memory and consciousness. Here Shariputra, all dharmas are defined by emptiness, not by birth or destruction, purity or defilement, completeness or deficiency. Therefore, Shariputra, in emptiness there is no form, no sensation, no perception, no memory, and no consciousness. No eye, no ear, no nose, no tongue, no body, and no mind. No shape, no sound, no smell, no taste, no feeling, and no thought. No element of perceptions from eye to conceptual consciousness. No causal link from consciousness to old age and death. No end of causal link from consciousness to old age and death. No suffering, no source, no relief, no path. No knowledge, no attainment, and no non-attainment. Therefore, Shariputra, without attainment, Bodhisattvas take refuge in Prajnaparamita and live without the wall of the mind. Without walls of the mind and thus without fears, they see through delusions and finally accomplish nirvana. All Buddhas, past, present, and future, also take refuge in Prajnaparamita. Excuse me. And realize on exalt perfect enlightenment. You should therefore know the great mantra of Prajnaparamita, the mantra of great magic, the unexcelled mantra. The mantra equal to the unequal, which is all suffering and is true, not false. The mantra in Prajnaparamita is spoken thus. Gathe gathe para gathe para samgathe bodhi swaha. So now we come to the actual meditation practice. Let me reach for my meditation timer because it's always nice to have a clue. Let us demystify Soto, Zens, or okay. Let us demystify Soto Zen's or Kaodong Chan's figurative aphorism to just sit. By breathing diaphragmatically during each inhalation. So to simplify this, as we breathe in, we're going to recite the first syllable of the word diaphragmatically. We're going to silently and mentally recite the word "die" as we breathe in. And as we breathe out, we're going to silently and mentally recite the verb ease, which is a synonym of relax. We're going to further demystify Soto Zen's or Kaodong Chen's figurative aphorism to just sit by practicing shorter inhalation and longer exhalation. Therefore, during the inhalation, silently and mentally recite the word short. During the exhalation, silently and mentally recite the word long. That's all we gotta do. The actual adjusting of the respiratory mechanism will occur subconsciously, which is terribly convenient. By the way, if you ever struggle with insomnia, then as you lay in bed, silently and mentally recite long, long, as opposed to short, long. Short, long will wake you up in the morning. Long, long will knock you out at night. This technique of short long is great to keep, help prevent you from falling asleep during meditation. We're going to further demystify Soto Zens or Kaodong Chans. And by the way, please forgive my pronunciation of Japanese and Chinese. Figurative aphorism to just sit by sitting nice and tall with each inhalation and physically relax with each exhalation. We're going to further demystify Cao Dong Chan's or Soto Zen's figurative aphorism to just sit by subtly grinning during each inhalation with the corners of our mouths, the apples of our cheeks, and the crow's feet of our eyes. If you've just joined us, welcome aboard. When you have a question about Buddhist meditation or Buddhist philosophy, simply type it in great detail in the chat window. As we breathe in, due to the mechanism of our sympathetic nervous system, we can mindfully notice the play of mind as silently and mentally we recite the pronoun this. I guess it's preposition, the preposition this. During each exhalation, due to the mechanism of our parasympathetic nervous system, we can meditatively relax into mind's non-graspable nature as silently and mentally we recite the verb ease, which is a synonym of relaxing. Or perhaps relax would be a better synonym. As we relax during our exhalation, all that we noticed during our previous inhalation can now feel as non-graspable as a vast empty void, like the illusion of the infinite azure sky on a bright and beautiful cloudless morn, which although is tantalizing to the eye, is non-graspable to the hand. Let us demystify Soto Zen's or Kaodong Chan's figurative aphorism to just sit. By breathing diaphragmatically during each inhalation, we're going to reduce this polysyllabic term to just its first syllable, Dai. During our inhalation, let us silently and mentally recite Dai. During our exhalation, let us silently and mentally recite the verb ease, which is a synonym of relax. We're going to further demystify Soto Zen's, or Kaodong Chan's, figurative aphorism to just sit by practicing a sharper inhalation and a softer exhalation. We're going to further demystify Soto Zen's or Cao Dong Chan's figurative aphorism to just sit by sitting nice and tall with each inhalation and physically relaxing with each exhalation. Let us seal this morning's practice with wishing love. May everyone be free from suffering. May everyone be happy. May no one be separated from the happiness. May everyone have balance from the tyranny of hating, craving, and clinging freed. In approximately, so if you feel that I have earned this, if you feel I have earned it, type something in the comment area, give this live stream a thumbs up, and share it on social media. In approximately 10 and a half hours, I would very much like to return to lead today's evening meditation. Until then, may you and yours be happy and healthy. And if you are as geeky as me, this is the way.